says that the problem is that people are being people are getting depressed because of climate activists. Okay, check this out.
Shouldn't even have any children. It's like, no, there's no excuse for that. There's zero excuse for that. I saw a professor at an event, something like this. He came out and trumpeted this bloody environmentally friendly house he built. And, you know, fair enough, man. It was a pretty interesting house, but not everybody had the $4 million that it took him to build it. And I'm not criticizing his money even. It's like, he's had some money. Good for him. He built a house. Okay. But then to trumpet that as a moral virtue, well, you're pushing it there. And then he came out to all the kids and he said, you know, my wife and I decided that we were only going to have one child. And I think that's one of the most ethical things we could have possibly done. And I would strongly encourage you to do the same. I thought, you son of a bitch. You get up in front of these young people. A lot of these kids were children of first-generation immigrants from China. And he showed all these images, you know, of these terrible factories in China, these endless rows of sterile mechanism that were subordinating all the Chinese people to this terrible, you know, capitalist machine. And I thought...
If you're still following this, it's about to get really weird.
I don't understand. Half the audience is looking at those factories and thinking, that's a hell of a lot better than struggling through the mud under Mao, buddy. And so,
one thing that shocked me most, I think, is the attitude of the manager. Like, yelling at workers is kind of a routine in the factories. There are still some facilities or mechanisms that prevents workers committing suicide. They have the nets in the stairs, and also all the windows, they have this ceiling-like cage where you can jump from the window.
I don't know where he thought he was, but to come out in front of all those kids and basically tell them that the whole human enterprise is so goddamn corrupt that the best thing they could possibly do is limit their multiplication, and to think of himself as a scholar and an educator, it was just, I did say something, by the way, it was rather uncomfortable, and he stomped off the stage. But that's no message for young people. There's no excuse for that. And you think, we're going to destroy the planet. We have to do this. We have to demoralize the youth to be ethical. It's like, yeah, really, that's your theory? You're going to demoralize young people to be ethical? That's your theory? It's like, you should go home and think about that for like a year. And I'm passionate about this, you know, because you have no idea how many people that's killing. You have no idea. I see people everywhere, all over the world. They're so demoralized.
But China's deliberate policy of using prisoners as slaves to boost the profits for Chinese export companies continues unchecked. And Western governments remain reluctant to rock the economic boat. As long as the world's consumer markets place a higher value on cheap products than they do on human life, the misery of 5 million prison slaves locked up behind these walls will continue.
Especially young people with a conscience, because they've been told since they were little that there's nothing to them but corruption and power. It's like, how the hell do you expect them to react?
So this is bizarre, obviously. There's a real difference between young people are told that you are made up of corruption and whatever, and, hey, we have some hard problems that we're facing and they need to be solved. And you might make choice. I mean, there's an entire movement. I think it's called the Antinatalist, which basically says, like, we can't bring people. We should all, everybody should stop reproducing because we are rapidly heading towards a lack of sustainability and on and on and on. Now, I happen to disagree with that. I think the way we solve our problems is actually by reproducing and creating people that are going to solve these problems. That's my view, because I guess I'm more optimistic than pessimistic. But this whole thing, weeping because people learn that things aren't looking so good in some senses, that it would be immoral to hide everyone from that. Now, I'm with you. We don't want to demoralize people. No, we want to say, hey, look at all these problems humanity has solved. And then here are the problems now facing us, and let's solve them. But I would be crying over how we're destroying the planet, not about how kids might find it upsetting that we're destroying the planet.
I did what I did for the good of the realm.
The realm? Do you know what the realm is? It's the thousand blades of Aegon's enemies. A story we agree to tell each other over and over till we forget that it's a lie.
But what do we have left once we abandon the lie? Chaos. A gaping pit waiting to swallow us all.
Chaos isn't a pit. Chaos is a ladder. Many who try to climb it fail. Never get to try again. The fall breaks them. And some are given a chance to climb, but they refuse. They cling to the realm, or the gods, or love. Illusions. Only the ladder is real. The climb is all there is.